Well, flower, but it is a small tree, is the dogwood. And one that's very close to my heart because it's our state flower here in North Carolina, as it is also in Virginia and maybe in other places. But one of my favorites, it is a tree, doesn't get very thick. And the legend goes it's because it was the tree that was chosen to crucify Christ on. And so it was almost cursed that it would never, you know, be a very big tree again. So you'll see, you know, see them growing through the woods here. Of course, there are other cultivars that have their pinks. I was even in Tokyo several years ago and saw a red dogwood, which was quite stunning. So this one is a tree. So you get a branch and then the petals, it's a four petal flower. So you're going to cut one of these for each flower that you want. There's these two go together. And then there's leaves to cut. And then you have this little star shape is what I call the calyx. And it kind of holds the shape of your flower on the branch. So you can cut this. I've cut it out of green because it doesn't need to be colored. And the little roll-up stamen, which will hold the bracts. The bracts are actually the flower of the tree. So let me get started here with the branch. You see, this doesn't tell you to cut two, but I do. I like to cut two for not only a little bit of dimension, I guess you call it. And if it's a woody branch, as opposed to a bush that may have green branches or stem, let me test my, there it is. I'll cut it out, the second piece, the underneath piece, out of brown. Now you've seen me probably cut other stems out of green if that were the case, that it was more of a bush rather than a tree. And then I just line up my one here. Now I cut this one out of white because I do like to color it. I like to see some shading on the branch. So let me grab my Copic here. You can do it with distressed inks. Just never use distressed oxide. The oxide kind of doesn't like working with tools, and you may get some streaking of gray. Now, I even turn it on the side here, and if I see any white from that white paper, I like to just, you know, run the marker, the alcohol marker, right along that edge so you just see brown. So let's put this in place first. I have one here that I've started. I've made this into a slimline card, and I'm actually going to add the second branch coming off of here. So a little bit of glue just on this underside here. Grab some more here. And I'm just going to have it coming off of here. Now, if you were just adding it to a bouquet, you may just be doing one branch, but we're going to do this elongated one to match with the card. So before I start on the petals here, I'm going to take my small ball stylus, and on this calyx, this little star shape, I'm cupping those, and I'm going to place them onto the branch so they can set while I'm doing the flowers. This gives it a little bit more stability. You saw that I did this with the sweet pea too. I had a calyx. Now let's put one right out here. There we go. Now, these very distinguished petals. Of course, they have that little reddish kind of staining on the edge, And I do it from this side, and I've made it so the tip of your alcohol pen can go right into it and let it bleed into the paper. This paper is my specialty paper, and it really takes the inks beautifully. But you see, it gives you a nice little bleeding effect. You want it to look natural. So that's just with R89 if you're a Copic person. Now the other thing is it has a little bit of shading on the inside of the petal. So I'm going to grab a little bit darker green here in the Pan Pastel and just shade that center. So you see when I place the stamen and you look down on it, you get that shading that's in there. Now they're all ready. And we'll take and put them on the molding pad. And let me grab my loop tool and we'll start shaping. I'm using my small loop tool and going from the outer part of the petal towards the center and giving those striations that they have. Just softening, restructuring the fibers of the paper and making it easier for you to shape. Now take your tweezers and right down the center, these have nice narrow points, so you're going to pinch right around it and then just roll down the outer edges of these petals. Now this one's been shaped, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to pinch and then this is the littler one that goes on top. And then using that small ball stylus again, cup right in the center on both those pieces. Now take a toothpick with some glue and right in that center there, go ahead and place some. You can see how shading in that center gives you the depth of the flower. Grab a little bit more glue and we'll set them on our branch. So it doesn't matter which tweezers you use. Go ahead, I'm gonna dip this in and set it on these little calyxes. And I'll use the tip of my tweezer just to press down. And a couple more made here. And then one more. There we go. Next we'll do the stamen. So with the stamen, you do want to cut those filaments. So I'm taking my little scissors here and just snipping them a little thinner. And take your tweezer and grab a hold of that tail that I give you. And with a toothpick here, right along that tail, go ahead and smear some glue. Now, I left the tail not covered, so hopefully my tip of my tweezer won't get too much glue on it. I'm gonna wrap it around and then pull it off and hope that it stays together. Now you're gonna kind of bend it out a bit. And here's where we want to use prills. This doesn't have pollen on it. It has these little tiny hard centers. They're called bracts. So we can mimic that by using the prills. They're actually like little seed pods there. I've got a couple here already made and dried. So I can add right into the center there. Looks like a little stalk of broccoli, I think, but it is a brack. This one's still a little wet, but I'm gonna put them in there anyway. I took off some of the, there we go. Next, we'll do the leaves. So I'm going to use a couple of greens that I like. This is YG99 and YG97. And I'm doing a little bit darker area down by the stem and then picking up that olivey color going up. And then just turning over and coloring it. Let's see, did I do this one? Yeah. So you get three on a on the plate. Again, with leaves, you can cut as many as you want. This is a tree that the leaves, you know, most flowering trees, you'll see the flowers come out, and then the leaves, when they fall off, I mean, when the flowers fall off, the leaves come on. So I've got my leaf pad, and I'm going to use my leaf tool. Right sides down, make that stem line. Gonna bend up on it. And I'm gonna use that bright green once more. And shade right down the center of that leaf. Now this one does have veins. So back onto your mat, right side up, and just kind of round the leaves or the veins going out from the stem line. Don't cross over that stem line. You don't want to ruin your line that you put down there and put dimension in. And then if you take your tweezers and pinch that stem line, pinch around it, and you can use your medium ball stylus just to kind of roll that little end, kind of ruching. I used to call that with draperies. So bring your card in, and let's just add some leaves and make this tree come alive. This would also be nice to really have maybe one of the sweet birds, like the robin or something, on it. I could have added that too. I love seeing the dogwood in the springtime. It puts that little whiteness in the forest. We've got several wild ones here in our woods in the back. There we go. And then, like before, let me grab my little ladybug. Let's put her over here. And then I'm gonna grab some more of that glaze. Just a little touch of glaze to her. When she dries, she'll have a nice shiny shell. There you go. That is the dogwood, one of the pretty springtime trees that blossom